look at me. Look at where I am. The Howard Stern interview again. And look at this.
Schwing.
I love her. Look at that. Huh? Isn't
nice
she cute?
Nice
Isn't that
coat.
Great?
Yes.
Look at that. Ooh. Yeah, I'm doing I'm doing it.
Just gonna get down together here.
Let me hug you. Hello.
Okay.
Let me hug you.
Ooh, you never kissed me before, Howard.
You never kissed me on the lips like that before. Hey, did you see that? Let's do that again. All right.
Gene Simmons.
All right, now, Patty Smythe.
I've never actually hugged you before.
That felt really good. I didn't realize how tall you were. How tall are you, Patty?
About 5'6".
You're 5'6". This is very exciting for me. This is somebody who I find very, very exciting. Patty Smythe. She's one hot mama. And I'm very attracted to you. I've made no secret about that. Let's explain to people at home who Patty is. You know, there are some people, and this is Patty's problem. She hasn't broken through, let's say, like a big, like your name is in a household name yet, is it?
No.
That's what we're working toward?
Yes.
That is what we're working here toward
let's
tonight.
Let's get a round of applause
but
for
you
that.
Have, yes.
Household appliance.
I think that Patty's videos would be played even more if she wore mini skirts and mini outfits.
Did you see the video for No Mistakes?
Yes, though? I did. As a matter of fact, I'm going to show both videos, both of the current videos.
But I showed more of my body in No Mistakes.
You did, you know? And I'm telling you.
You asked me to, and I did.
You are foxing up your image. It's very beautiful. It really is. Come on, let's kiss again. Hello. Oh, yeah. Oh. And you stay in great shape, too. You're happy
you.
That you work out with weights, true?
Yes, I
and
do.
And you like showing off your arms? Yes,
yes,
because you
people
pump iron.
People like me to show off my arms. So I always had muscular arms, though. I think it's just more a genetic thing.
Let us, let's
Let
explore
me see your arms.
No, you don't want to see my arms right now.
But you've been working out, haven't
no,
you?
No, I have not been working out. But let me just first show you a video, okay? This first video I'm going to show is the one you do with Don Henley. All right, take
That's
a little look at this. Check out the
see
outfit.
My body.
Take a look at this one. Now that I like. I like the top. And you're showing off your breasts in that, are you not, Patty?
Yes. Well, I live in L.A. now, so, you know, breasts are a prominent theme here, so.
But you don't even need breast implants because you have cleavage.
Well, it's the dress helped me, too.
Yes, you do.
That was one of those pump-up dresses.
All right, stop that for a second now. That look I like. Yes. I think that's good, but yet you wore a very long dress. You never show off your legs in your videos, do you?
I did, but I haven't for a while.
You haven't for a while. Are you planning on showing off
your
legs?
On the next video, I'm going to show off
my legs. But you recognize that that's important to do that. Because guys buy a lot of these records based on how a woman looks. True? That's right. Okay.
Now, I don't think so, Howard.
Now, let's take a look at your other video, the one without Don Henley. Okay? Take a look at this one. Let's check out the outfit and see what happened.
Oh.
Now, it's more cleavage.
Again.
You're enjoying showing your cleavage now.
Yeah, I mean, I love my cleavage now.
I love you showing off your cleavage.
I never had cleavage before, see?
You look absolutely adorable in those videos.
Thank you, Howard.
I would love to see you in a miniskirt on those things.
I am going to wear a miniskirt. Let's do a Vulcan thing.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm going to wear a miniskirt the next video.
Patty, I sense that you're having an attraction for me right now. I really do. I think that you're actually considering that I might be attracted to you.
You look very, very good, and I know you're a good dad, so, you know, these are like, this is a good property.
And
here.
If I were to tell you right now in a very serious way that I just received a call from New York that my wife died, would you believe me and that now I am free to date you? Would you believe that?
No, I wouldn't believe
it. It is true. My wife, I'm gonna be very serious right now, and I'm going to talk to the people at home. I received word that my wife was in a horrible car accident, a disfiguring car accident. And,
is she dead or disfigured?
She is disfigured, and she is dead, and she died. She really died, and you would be a great mother to my three children. You really would. You would absolutely be great, and you're the one...
The Brady Bunch kind of a thing,
Are
right?
you saying that you, if I was single, you would consider dating me?
I might.
You've dated some good guys. You dated Don Henley, the guy in the video.
I never dated Don Henley, although we've been friends for a long time, but it wasn't really a romantic
Never thing. Had sex with Don Henley.
Never had. You ask me this every time, and I tell you,
you
no.
You think I remember what I ask you each time? I'm totally obsessed.
Well,
no, I remember that you were married.
Yes.
Patty has a very interesting background. She married a guy who I felt she should never have married. I felt it was
you
wrong.
You and everybody else on the planet. Let me just
She married
say
a guy named Richard Held of the Void Oids.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew it was wrong the day you married him. You marry guys, you're attracted to men who have like a biker kind of image or a bad boy image, is that right?
I think so, yeah.
You would never
bad men, that's my type.
You would never date a guy with like short hair and or like a very ordinary looking kind of guy, is that true?
No, I have. I don't have a type, Howard. I'm telling you, it's like if you line up like the six, you know, like major guys that I've dated, it's like there's no defining thread except that they're all bad.
And what's a guy have to do to get into your pants? I mean, to really win you over. That's what I want to know. I mean,
they have to be funny, Howard.
I can't imagine what it would be like to have you in bed with me, and you, where you were seriously.
I can't imagine that.
I can't
right
imagine
now.
Like you kissing me and stuff, and then disrobing me.
I've never actually disrobed anyone.
You never took off a guy's pants or anything like that? Never. Smythe has never done that.
No.
Oh, really? Well, you're as exciting as my dead wife. I must tell you. Maybe you wouldn't be such a good mother to my children. But Don Henley was not a romantic interest.
No.
But you marry, you at a young age, you start in with singing, 7 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And you, see, I did some research.
Oh, yes.
All right, wait a second. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a break. I'm going to come back and find out what a guy has to do to get into your pants. Find out how a guy can make love to Patti Smythe.
You should get some guy who's been there and ask them what
I should find. Are any of those guys that you brought with you today, are any of them your boyfriend?
No.
Do you have a current boyfriend?
No.
You do not have a boyfriend.
No.
You're completely single.
So is your wife really dead?
My
or
wife
not?
Is really dead. She's really dead. You know, this is what kills me. I would have died for a girl like you in high school. I really would have, but these girls were not available to me. You were not available to me in high school.
No, I was high in high school.
You were high all the time in high school. All right, listen, when we come back, here's what I want to do. You brought your guitarist with you, right?
Yes, I did.
So we're going to do a little number, mm-hmm. and you'll sing it to me like I'm your boyfriend?
Yes, I will.
You
will
like you have love for me?
Yes, and now watch your face turn red.
Yeah.
I love that.
You will sing to me like I am your boyfriend?
Yes, I will.
Oh, that's going to be a real treat. Not for you, for me. And we're going to talk about what a man has to do to win you over. When we come back on the Howard Stern interview. Look who I'm here with, Patti Smythe, who my job, yes. Oh, look at that. Whoa.
And Rusty Anderson.
Yes, this is Rusty Anderson. Now, Rusty, you a married man?
No.
You're not?
No.
How old are you?
Why are you a proposition? Or
come here. Let me make out with you. Now how old are you?
I'm 34.
And you're attracted to Patti?
Oh yeah.
You are. And you two have never made love?
I don't work with anyone. I'm not.
You guys work together?
Yes.
And you've never made love? Never.
Just gardening.
He's an attractive guy. I would think that you would
cute.
Go for him.
I thought about it.
And you have. And nothing ever happens between the two of you.
No, it's a professional relationship.
I think the two of you would be lovely together. I really do.
Aww.
I'd like to see that. I like to have photographs of that. Of course, let's say now we are here with Patti Smythe. She just did a duet thing with Don Henley. That sold a lot of records. So
yes.
You have a lot of money now.
Yeah, I'm supposed to. Like this year, you know, it takes like 6 months before like that big fat check comes. So
when
it's
supposed
to come soon. March.
When do you get that?
March or April.
And how much money, seriously, how much money are you expecting? Several hundred thousand dollars?
Well, I asked somebody, a friend of mine who had like a number one single too, and she said that she made like $500,000 the first check.
$500,000?
The first check! Howard! Swing!
Oh, my wife Thank just you. Died again. Yeah, baby. Rich, $500,000, and you'll take that money and you have an accountant who will invest that for you? Or will you be cavalier about it?
I'm not going to do that again.
What?
I did that before. I was cavalier the last
You time. Were cavalier. You have mm-hmm. no money from your days with Scandal? You had many hit records?
No, I never had to get a day job, so I lived on it, but I didn't like buy anything except lots of clothing.
Right.
You know, and facials and really things like that.
So know? When you get this money this time, who will invest this money for you? You have a guy set up?
Yeah, I do have.
And you will put it into serious investments?
I hope so, yeah.
I see, because
as opposed to, like, you know.
Because even with your
comedic investments.
Because you have a 7-year-old daughter.
Yes.
And you have to support her, right?
I have to be responsible now. Now I've learned, yes.
Your husband is sending child support?
Well, technically.
Is he sending anything? Has he sent you anything in the last year? He has not sent you any money. Really?
No, he actually sends other things.
What does he send?
He sends money, but it's not really much.
You know, I got to tell you something.
Packages from the IRA.
That's unbelievable. I mean, you know, that's got to be great. You have a lot
but
of...
excuse me, that 85% of fathers do not pay child support who are ordered by the court. I mean, he does pay his child support, and sometimes he's behind, and then he catches up.
So you have a lawyer who goes after him?
No.
No, you don't care.
I'm not going to do that.
Boy, what a great wife you would be. What a great woman to divorce. She doesn't care if the child support shows up. I tell you, all these other women are very nervous about child support.
Well, if it was like $3,000 a week, believe me, I would care.
Right.
You know what I mean? But it's not.
It's
so
not $3,000 a week.
No. So.
I knew you shouldn't have married that guy. I always
I
said it. I'd be
everybody
a much more...
Everybody said it. You, Don, everybody.
I said it. I'd be a much more suitable husband. I really would have been. I'm husband
but
material.
But you were married already then.
I was
anyway.
Married, unfortunately. But my wife has died. We just got word. So I'm free to date you. Where will we go on our date tonight? All right. Now,
can you dance?
Do me a favor. Pretend that I am your boyfriend right now. All right? Forget about my wife. Forget about my responsibilities. Pretend I am your boyfriend. and perform your new hit record for me. Okay. And look at me, though, like you're really in love with me.
Okay.
And even, like, touch my hair during the song. And I'll touch...
But how did you just get red in the face when I do that?
Can I feel free to touch you during the song?
Yes.
I can?
Yes, you can.
And that will not disturb you while you sing?
You can hold my hand a little bit, but you can't get too, because it might throw me off.
All right, but I can
I might get too excited.
But I can touch you. Can I kiss your neck?
It's been a long time.
Can I kiss your neck during the song?
No.
It has been a long time?
Yeah. You can kiss my arm.
Really? Mm-hmm. When is the last time you had a sex? When is the last time you had a man? So the people at home know. Come on. When is the last time you had
last
a man?
Year.
Last year? It's been a year since you had a man?
Well, technically, no.
Is it because you're afraid of the AIDS virus and you're...
Well, you have to be careful. Yeah,
you have to be careful.
And I was never really, you know...
You're not that sexually...
That loose.
You're not that loose. I like that. You'd be the perfect wife for me because I have not made love to a new woman in 19 years.
No, so wait a minute, Howard. Really, like, you know, remember when you used to, like, have all those broads and G-strings and little things? Didn't you ever, like,
I have
nail
never,
any of them?
No, I did not nail any of them, and I could have, but I am faithful to my wife.
I think that's really great. Let's give him a round of applause for that.
I believe I deserve it, because believe me, I have my temptation. Hey, maybe...
That's amazing.
Let me tell you something, my friend. Maybe I'm not a pretty boy like you, and where it's come easy for you for women, which I'm sure you got that James Taylor kind of look, and James wishes he had that head of hair. Believe me, I'm sorry. Never, let me tell you something. I had a tough time getting girls, and believe me, I'll tell you, it's tempting knowing I could have someone like you in the sack, and that would be great. All right, now, remember, I'm your boyfriend while you do this. Do we have time to do this here, or do I have to take a break? Want me to take a break, and then we'll do it?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to take a break, and Patti Smyth will sing to me as I am her boyfriend.
You are my lover man.
And then I will tell you about her connection with Van Halen. We're going to talk about that a little bit right after these words with Patti Smyth. Wild. It's going to be wild.
That's right. We're going to be
It's going to be great. Oh, I'm very excited about it. Very aroused. And by the way, a lot of people don't know this. Patti Smyth was supposed to be the lead singer in the group Van Halen.
Well, I wasn't supposed to be. I mean, he asked me to be the lead singer.
Eddie Van Halen.
I only ever talk about that with you. You know that?
Eddie Van Halen was attracted to you. True? He wanted to be your boyfriend.
He wanted me to be the singer.
He wanted, but he liked you romantically, didn't he?
I think he might have had an innocent crush on me.
He had a crush. Who
but
wouldn't
he was
have a
married.
Crush?
He was married, so he was, you know.
Because you sing like a friggin' nightingale and you look good to boot. I mean, how many times do you get that combination?
Thank
it's
you.
Very rare. You know, and you're not singing like wimpy, crummy songs like Mariah Carey. You're singing rock and roll, right? I mean, you're really happening. Okay.
That's right.
So that's nice. And when you're in love with a guy, do you actually sing to him sometimes at home? Like you say, I'm working on this, honey, and I want you to hear this?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, that's what I want right now. That's what I want now.
Working on this.
You're working on this. You come into the room. I'm sitting there relaxing, and you want to sing this to me. Go ahead. Here we go. Patti Smyth. All right, here we go.
You're going to get embarrassed if I stare at
you. And nobody else is in the room except us.
That's right.
All right.
He's not here.
I get real embarrassed by this. All right.
And you stare at him, too, like he's your boyfriend.
He is my boyfriend.
The summer is gone, I can't believe it went so fast. Why do only the cold and lonely times seem to last? Now it's late at night, I watch you sleeping, I wanna wake you up. Tell you I'm sorry, though I know I can't make it up. And I made my mistakes now, baby, but I did the best I could. And it takes what it takes, and sometimes it takes longer than it should to just live the kind of life that we both have been dreaming of. There are no mistakes in love. I walk through a fire with my dreams just to pull you. I'm just so hard on you. But baby, a change has got to come, and I can't see. After another winter's gone, well, who's gonna
rescue me. There are no mistakes now, baby. We did the best we could. And it takes what it takes, and sometimes it takes much more than it should to just make the choices that we both have been dreaming of. There are no mistakes in love. The nights are much colder now, and I feel the need to have you near. Well, maybe we could start all over. I feel a change in the now, baby, we do the best we can. It just takes what it takes, and sometimes it's so hard to understand. And just take the chances that we all have been dreaming of. There are no mistakes in love.
You're in love with me. She was like in love with me or something. I think you're in love with me or something. Either that was good acting or you're in love with me.
Do you know how hard it is to sing when you want to laugh?
Really?
Oh, you know, yes.
You almost wanted to French me during that.
I almost kissed you.
She almost kissed me during that. I thought you were going to go for it at the end there. I thought you were going to kiss me at the end.
I almost did, but.
Yeah, he ruined everything, though. He's looking the whole time. Supposed to turn your head. You guys are great together.
He was your boyfriend.
You guys are real good. We'll take a break. We'll be right back with Patti Smythe. Has to show off and play the guitar. Anyway, of course, Patti Smythe is here. She has a couple of hit records now, right?
Yes,
this
yes.
is going very well. The record company likes you.
Yes, they like me. They like me. They really like me.
And record companies had turned you down when you went solo, right?
No, as a matter of fact, no. When I left Columbia, there were three or four record companies that were just standing there waiting, actually, which is kind of nice.
Mm-hmm.
But no, nobody turned me down. Oh, maybe someone turned me down, but for one that turned me down, four wanted me, so... Who didn't want me? Somebody didn't want me. I don't remember anymore.
And going back to the Van Halen story, just one last time, I want people to understand this. You were approached before Sammy Hagar.
Yes.
You were the guy when Van Halen broke up that was going to be the front person for the band.
The guy.
You were the guy.
I was the guy. I was the guy who was 8 months pregnant when he asked
me. And I can't believe that anybody would turn down Van Halen.
I wasn't thinking about it. I mean, I think in retrospect later, I went like, wow, why did I do that? But I remember sitting at a table and Paul Schaefer was there and Danny Kortchmar, and like this silence fell over the table.
Now, why was Paul Schaefer there?
Because they had done the Letterman show and I knew him and Val was on it. He was playing. So I went up to the show and then we had dinner. And he asked me in front of this whole table full of people, and the silence that fell when I went, no, I don't think so.
And he turned to you and he said, I want you to be the lead singer.
I'm going to have to find someone else if you don't do it, he said to me.
Really? And you said no. That just like that. You didn't think about the millions
said
of dollars.
I can't.
The millions of dollars doesn't turn you on?
I wasn't thinking about
You're not
money.
Into material possessions?
I am now.
You are now into it. You're right. Now you're thinking about material back
now
then
I'm
you were.
I'm thinking about those millions of dollars.
Yes, absolutely. Patti Smythe, my girlfriend, now that my wife is dead, I want to thank you for coming on.
Can we get engaged?
That was yes, we're absolutely engaged. Okay. And of course, Patti didn't have time to talk about all her little buddies. Like Carrie Fisher and all her little Hollywood friends, because she's living out here in California now, and she's hanging. You're hanging out with who? Who are your two biggest name friends? Carrie Fisher and who else?
Well, I guess Don is my
Don Henley,
friend.
And you that's go over to his house and hang out.
Sometimes, yes.
I see. Well, mm-hmm. That's for another story. And are you ever in mini dresses at his house? Does he ever come out in his underpants?
He's in mini dresses sometimes.
He's a good-looking guy, right?
At his house. Yeah, he's a very good-looking
guy. And he walks out of his bedroom in his underpants?
No, he has a miniskirt on for
He has
me.
A miniskirt.
Because he knows I like that in a guy.
And you have not dated a guy in a year?
No, I have. I just said, well, look, it's just, we're only barely into 1993. That was the point about it's been a year.
Oh, I see. But you're dating guys.
Yes, I am dating guys. And that's fun.
And you haven't had sex with any guy.
Any
no guy's been able
guys.
To close the deal with you.
No.
What's
not
the furthest a guy gets with you? Just kissing and stuff like I did?
I won't even kiss anyone right now. I'm not into it.
Really?
Except I kissed you. You're the first guy I've kissed
well,
in
I'm
2 months.
Well, I'm safe. Everybody knows I'm safe. All right. Anyway, we have to go. That wraps it up on the EO.
I do want to say that I have a lesbian relationship with Carrie, though.
You have a lesbian relationship with Carrie Fisher? Would you ever try lesbianism?
She's the last person I really kissed.
Would you ever try lesbianism?
No, I haven't had a lesbian experience. And
You're not interested in it?
No, not like per se, but I feel like I've missed something. Because you've had a lesbian experience,
haven't you? No, I'm serious now. You would like to probably be with another girl and try that once, wouldn't you?
No, but
would you try that at my hotel tonight?
I feel like I missed it.
What about if you and Carrie Fisher come over to my hotel tonight and try out some lesbianism?
Let's call her and see.
All right, that's Patti Smyth. Make sure to get her new album right now. And I want to thank you for playing the guitar, too.
Thank
that was real good.
Steve.
All right. And
if we have sex, we'll let you know.
Yeah, I might get some sex off her later. Right here on this, what do you call this again? A banquette.
This is a very nice banquette.
This is a very nice one.
Yes.
We'll see you next time on the Howard Stern interview. Patti Smyth.